you. Thank you. Yes, yes, we're so excited here in the studio. Yes, I think that's pretty clear. Yes, good, good, good monkey yells, good gorilla yells. It's very appropriate. We've got some, simian noises being made because this is truly a historic week because after years of struggle, he's finally free. Ivan the gorilla, ladies and gentlemen. He's out of the P&I store. He's out of Tacoma. Ivan is out of Tacoma. Although it sounds like he's here in our studio, he actually is out of Tacoma. He was flown to Atlanta. And the day after he was gone, they turned his cage into a Starbucks. I mean, it's like the day. It seems to be everywhere. They're popping up everywhere. Oh, good. Applause for Starbucks tonight. This is a really a hyped up crowd. That's good. Ivan actually, interestingly enough, Ivan is a lowland ape from the Belgian Congo, now known as Zaire for those of you who are keeping score. Principal export, I believe, is copper. But anyway, that's where Ivan's from. But animal psychologists say that he actually thinks of himself more like a Bellevue housewife, which I think it makes. It makes sense. You know, he's around 30 years old and spends most of his life in a shopping mall. So, I mean, it's just sort of. You gotta wait for the punchline there. And I was like, I was gonna explain it there. Housewife, and that was funny. I don't know, that's good. Not the way. Anyway, it was strange that he was in a store. He was in a store for atmosphere. It was like a gorilla there. Now, Nordstrom's, you know, they have a guy playing a grand piano, right? In Tacoma, it's like, let's put a gorilla in the middle of the store. It's like atmosphere. And it's, if you were there, you certainly can attest to the fact that it was atmosphere. You know, Costco, they, you know, not to be outdone, they have a pallet of gorillas in the middle of Costco. I think REI, I believe, now has a nun singing, "Climb Every Mountain," which is good. And over at Chubby and Tubby, they've got a guy there who plays "Oh Susanna" with his armpit. You can do that right on his armpit. So I'd suggest, you know, check it out. Ivan, a lot of very careful preparations for the move. Ivan was drugged for his flight. They thought it could be, yes. All right, applause for drugs, also good. They drugged Ivan. They thought it would be too upsetting for him, to actually drive through Tacoma. You know, conscious would be. Might look out the window. You never know what might happen, you know. And the flight was kind of full on the way to Atlanta. And you know how that is. You know, you're sitting in your seat, looking down the aisle, watching the other passengers coming in, and you can always spot the one they're going to sit next to you, right? Oh, great, the gorilla. You know, like. I bet the gorilla's gonna. Yeah, there. Wouldn't you know? Got a gorilla next to me, always. Yeah. But actually, the flight went real well. We have some news footage of his arrival in Atlanta, which we thought you might like to see. So can we see some of that there? He's actually had a private jet actually there. I believe he's going. There's Ivan. There he is. There he's waving. A lot of people there in Atlanta to welcome him. Got the tire there. Look, warm welcome there. See. This I think is good. Look. Got a limo there. Look at that. You know, Ted Turner sent that for him there, you know, in Atlanta. It's real nice. Look at that. What a warm welcome you got there. You know, much better home. Ivan, good luck. Isn't that great that Ivan is like, yeah, he's got a good place. He's going to a good place. It's a good time to move to Atlanta. He relocated just in time for the Summer Olympics. They're going to be down there in Atlanta. And I'm guessing that actually Ivan may get a chance to actually light the flame. Wouldn't that be great? Ivan walking up there to turn it on. So that's good. There's a lot of things. He's got a lot to look forward to in Atlanta. But of course, he's going to be missing Tacoma. You got to figure that. He's not going to be able to eat Nally's potato. Yeah. No more Nally's potato chips and washing it down with Heidelberg, you know, which he did pretty much every lunch. That's got to be, you know, sad. So they're trying to make him feel at home in Atlanta. So the zookeepers, what they do, they're driving around the cage and just shooting guns into the air, which is like just, they got that going. It's, you know, sort of settling him down. And they've installed speakers in the gorilla compound there so they can play a tape that says, "Lumber, line one. Lumber, line one." home. Move is for the best, though, you know. He was pretty bummed out that the Eagles had canceled their show at the Tacoma Dome anyway, so wanted to get out of there, and they let him bring his tire swing, which is good, and all-weather radial, no studs on it, except, of course, for Ivan. But he's got his exercise covered, and exercise, of course, is very important, and now that, you know, we're heading into the fall, this is no time to slack off, and we've got a few helpful tips just for you. Take a look.
Almost Live training film number 72, Getting in Shape. Part 1, The Discovery. While pulling on your Levi's, you make a disturbing realization. They're hard to button. In fact, almost impossible. Part 2, Taking Action. You have 5 options. The gut suck. The shimmy down. Carpet buttoning. The pogo. And the cover up. Part 3, Getting Serious. Go to the store and buy equipment for every known sport. Then show the world you're serious. Strap it all to your car, including your personal trainer.
Oh, but you're not trying. Let's go.
Then come home, put the equipment in the closet, never to be seen again. Yes. Take inspiration from fitness shows on television and resolve to build some muscle. Part 4. Join a gym. Select a small, intimate gym where the exercise equipment is always in use. No vacancies now. Better come back later. In the meantime, go down the hall and check out the women's aerobics class. And here's a tip. Take a good shower before going to the weight room. The effect will be very impressive. Part 5, a healthy diet. And that means salad. Anything on lettuce is a salad, and therefore healthy. For example, a tossed dinner salad, a fried pork rind salad, a cheeseburger deluxe salad, or a frosted animal cookie with sprinkle salad. Part 6, bigger pants. Bigger pants button with ease. Now you can relax and watch your exercise shows in comfort. This has been a successful fitness program.
All right, stay with us. We've got a great show, and we'll be right back. So you can...
Get your grandparents' candy here.
Come get your grandparents' candy.
Step right up for your grandparents' candy.
Don't be shy. Yes, ma'am.
What do you have?
Well, you got your small ball of candy corns and butterscotch all stuck together.
You got your large ball, which also includes stale mints and licorice.
This really takes me back. But something's missing.
Grandparents had cats, right?
That's right.
Your grandparents' candy with a little fur on it.
Oh, great.
$2. Oh. Thank you.
Get your grandparents' candy here.
Hey, get your grandparents' candy.
Step right up, don't be shy. Grandparents' candy right here.
Candy.
Smoking ban begins today. State's new rule is strictest in nation. Hello. I'm Jane Ryder, and this is Today Tonight. And tonight we're going to talk about the new state ban on smoking in offices in Washington State. On my right is... Bill Hornblower. All right, let's start with Franklin Clemens, an apologist for the tobacco industry.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No. By apologist, I mean that you defend the tobacco industry no matter what.
Oh, yes, that's right. Thanks for having me on the show.
Oh, Mr. Hornblower, good evening.
Thanks.
Mr. Hornblower owns an electronics company, and he's in charge of enforcing the smoking ban at his office, which is tough because he is a smoker himself.
I'm a former smoker. I gave it up. Don't do it anymore.
All right. How is the changeover to a non-smoking office going for you so far?
Fine. It's going good.
Now, as a smoker...
Hey, excuse me. I left my lights on. I gotta go.
All right. Mr. Clemens... You favor smoking in offices.
Oh, yes, that would be so nice.
Mr. Clemens, you are aware that smoking kills.
Sure, a little, yeah. Well, last year, smoking did kill 2 people.
two people?
But I have a chart that shows some things that kill more than cigarettes.
And what would those be?
See, here's the two from smoking. And then guns killed 12,000 people. Serial killers killed 8,000. Mary Hart's voice killed 178 people. And 16 people died in accidents involving mittens.
All right. Let's stop being ridiculous and talk about the dangers of secondhand smoke.
You know something? I'm so glad you brought that up because we have a plan to cut down on secondhand smoke. We want to pass a law that would require everyone to smoke. Then it would all be firsthand smoke and there wouldn't be any secondhand smoke.
You want to make it a law that everyone in an office has to smoke?
Okay.
Oh, Mr. Hornblower, good to have you back. Did you get your lights?
My what?
Never mind.
Okay.
You were going to tell us how smoking ban has worked at your company.
Good. Good. It's a great law. I agree 100% with the health nuts. I mean regulators, the health regulators. I agree with those guys.
Well, good. I'm glad to hear that it's been working out so well for you.
Geez, I left my car running.
Mr. Clemens, I understand the tobacco industry is already looking for other markets to make up for your setbacks in the workplace.
Oh, yes. We're trying to get poor people in third world countries to smoke. That will be nice.
And that's not all. I understand you're also planning a new line of cigarettes targeted at children.
Oh, no, I don't think so.
Well, we've uncovered some mock-ups for new cigarettes that are geared toward kids. Would you like to see them?
Gee, are you sure we have the time? I mean, we should...
Here's one that's called Beverly Hills 90210120s. Now, that's not aimed at kids.
No, those are for people who like to memorize zip codes.
Okay. What about Wedgie 100s?
Oh, no. No. They're aimed at carpenters.
All right, how about... Smoke Dick, Smoke Jane, Smoke Menthol.
No. Those are pretty obviously meant for school teachers.
Mm-hmm. Here's one you can't possibly deny is targeted at kids. Smokes for 15-year-old boys.
No, they're aimed at men who want to feel like they're 15 again.
Well, we're out of time for tonight. And I would like to thank my guests, the apologist, Mr. Clemens.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And Mr. Hornblower.
Thanks. Great being here.
Join us next time on Today Tonight. How about Patty?
Amplification for Almost Live provided by American Music, now open in Tacoma.
First, there was Wonder Bra. Wonder Brief. Wonder Brief's unique design maximizes lift and volume using our patented ego extender. Wonder Brief. Cause hey, women have faked it for years. It's our turn.
I wonder.
Wonder Brief. It's too good to be true.
And now for the Applebee's new Wonder Jock.
John, here's my report. Three suspects believed responsible for a string of fast food robberies in the area were finally nabbed by police this week at an Arby's in Auburn. Police became suspicious when they saw that many people walking into an Arby's. In a related story, the fast food robbery suspects claimed that they were only trying to get some change and then decided to supersize it. A recent poll shows that most Washington state families are happy with the quality of their lives. The poll was conducted by telephone in a random survey of people whose last name is Weyerhaeuser. Evergreen State College is offering a 32-credit course based on Star Trek. A spokesperson for the college insists that this is no Mickey Mouse course. That course won't be offered until spring quarter. The Bellevue Downtown Association favors increased bus service over light rail. In the Bellevue proposal, however, buses would only head out of town, since anyone who actually would ride a bus has no business in Bellevue anyway. Well, John Tesh of Entertainment Tonight will be playing his easy listening instrumental piano pieces on October 22nd at Tacoma's Pantages Theater. However, Tacoma resident Yanni says he'll skip the concert because, quote, to tell you the truth, Tesh's music seems kind of boring to me. Well, Governor Lowry has returned from 3 days of talks in Mexico. The governor described the talks as frustrating, saying that it felt like we weren't even speaking the same language. Finally, local Payless stores are offering flu shots through November for $10. Local Kmarts have responded by offering to wipe your nose for a buck. This has been the John Report. Thank you.
Come get your open bag of spiral noodles that we found lying on the street just over there.
Step right up. It won't last long. Get an open bag of spiral noodles we found lying on the street just over there.
Yes, this good-looking couple right over here.
Oh, yeah. Well, do you have any linguine?
No, just this open bag of spiral noodles we found lying on the street just over there.
How about a box of elbow macaroni that was found under a car seat?
You want that guy over there.
Box of elbow macaroni found under a car seat. Box of elbow macaroni found under a car seat.
Come get your open bag of spiral noodles we found lying on the street just over there.
Hey, how about an open bag of spiral noodles we found lying on the street just over there?
Hi, I'm Bill Staten. As you probably know, earlier this week, Bill Gates bought a rival computer company called Intuit, which specializes in personal finance software. And even though I don't have stock in either company, I think that's a good move on Bill's part. But you know what occurred to me? That the purchase might have caused some confusion when Bill got home that day. So I've written a little play about it, which we'd like to perform for you now. I'll play the role of Bill Gates, and Nancy Guppy will play the part of Bill's wife, Melinda. Honey, I'm home.
Hi, honey. How was work?
Great. I bought Intuit today.
Bought into what, dear?
No, Intuit. I bought Intuit.
Yes, I heard you, but into what?
Not into anything. I bought Intuit.
Yes, dear, but into what?
Not into what, darling? Into it.
What?
The company.
What company?
Intuit.
Don't start with me, rich boy.
What?
You're making me mad.
Why? Because I bought into it?
Shut up.
You shut up.
You shut up.
You shut up.
Well, with that little dramatic flourish, that's just about all the time that we have tonight, but I just want to say once again, on behalf of all the Almost Live staff, we want to beam our welcome, as does the studio audience here, to Ivan, who is now trying to make a new home for himself in Atlanta. We hope you get to light that torch, Ivan. We're going to miss you in Tacoma, and we'll see you next week. Bye-bye.
Normal right here.
Step right up and find out if you're normal.
Just $1 to find out if you're normal. Yes, sir.
Yeah, when I'm eating cereal in the morning, I'll push the cereal over to one side of the bowl, and then I'll drink the milk first.
Come see the freak, everybody.
$1 to see the cereal freak. Step right up.
He pushes the cereal to one side, drinks all the milk.
No one knows why. Come see the freak.
He's a cereal freak.
He's a freak, folks. Come on over and see him.
You got him right here, cereal freak.
Step right up. Be a freak.